Hey y'all.
Hi.
Me and Tegan are at Earth Fair right now. I just got finished teaching my dance class.
Hi.
I'm so hungry. So we're gonna get some of this delicious, awesome pizza from here. Today's topic, we're not gonna be on here long because we're exhausted. We're at Earth Fair. See, I'm hopefully they still have some delicious yummies for us. So come on, Stinkies. Can you get a smoothie? Can I have a smoothie? We'll see what they got going on here. Hey, is there pizza left? There is. Hi.
I have two slices here, and then I got one slice of cheese right there.
Oh, yummies. Can I have the pepperonis?
Two?
Yes, please. Right. Thank you. We're starving like Marvin.
Starving like Marvin.
Yes, we are. Yeah. We're live on on FaceTime, on what do you call it?
Facebook.
Facebook, yeah. Let me see it. Can I look
if
at it?
Yeah, I will let you see it. That's it.
Okay, good. Yes. Yum. Yummy. Stop, Tiggy. Say hi. Tegan left her sweatshirt at my dance class.
Yeah.
So she's wrapped up in her blanket.
Blankie.
I want a macaroon cookie too. Hello, hello. Oh, thank you, baby doll. All right, have a good night. Thank you. You too. We got delicious pizza from Earth Fair. I hope if any of you guys ever come to visit me in Michigan, what'd you say?
I want a smoothie.
Tegan, no, it's time to go. We don't have time for that. Hey, which one should we go to? Okay, thank you. I choose you, John.
All right, sounds cool.
All right, good. Hold
Did
on.
Do you have a reward?
I do. I don't feel like doing that right now, though.
No problem.
Thank you.
It's
going to
be
$3.49. Okay, hold on. Ooh, thank you. We're exhausted and tired.
Yeah, no,
we just taught dance. Well, I just taught dance. I'm tired. My child left her sweatshirt. Get the money, Tegan. Thank you.
Have a good
See
time.
You later. Bye, y'all. All right, you too. Come on, Tegan. Be careful because the floor is wet. All right, hold on. We're about to live stream in the car. Don't look back. Come on, baby. Tegan. Mm-hmm. Did you get the money?
Yeah.
Did you get the money? You got the chow?
Yeah.
You got the chow?
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
Yes.
All right, get in your seat. Hold on. We're going to sit in here real quick. Hurry, baby. Who's on here with us? Okay, go ahead. Go ahead, baby. Get in. All right. Whew, goodness gracious. Because you pressed the thing. Alright, get in. Give me my money. If you ain't got my money, I'ma give me it. Alright.
I'm sleeping.
Okay, hold on. We're gonna do this live stream real quick. Don't look back. Hold up. Oh, goodness.
Hi guys.
Hi everybody. Oh, it's my baby.
Who?
Caitlin's on here.
Caitlin?
That's Tegan. Caitlin's on here. That's the baby. We love you, Caitlin. All right, so check it. All right, so I just got finished teaching my dance class. I'm listening to some Bible. I need some. Okay, hold on. Somebody's texting me. Lord have mercy. Okay, look. Don't look back. This is all we got to say about this topic. We're not going to hold them,
hungry.
Are we?
Give me my
okay,
pizza.
Here. Don't eat my pizza, Tegan. Just here. You have
Bye.
Yours. Just eat yours. Here. Don't just eat that. Here's some hand sanitizer. Lord have mercy. You just make poor choices sometimes, honestly. She says she loves you. She says she loves us, Tegan. We love you too. You know that.
I love you more.
She says she loves you more. Okay. Don't look back. After you.
Have,
it don't matter, Tegan. I want you to get your fill, okay? Get what you want and then just leave the other one to me. Okay, so, because you're not going to eat that whole thing anyway.
Yeah, like
that. Okay, so check it. Don't look back. After you have been taken up out of a situation, don't turn back around and then go back into that same situation. Because that's disrespectful. For instance, this is really hard because if I say this story, then it's going to put me in a situation, but I might just say it. Have you guys ever been in a situation where you have been delivered from something, but you keep on turning, like returning back to that situation? I have been there. This lady said to me one time, I'm not going to say nobody's name on here because you don't know, people want their names said on here and stuff. But this lady who was mentoring me for a short time said to me, Remy, you cannot become part of the culture that God sent you to redeem. Now, I've told this story to several people, and many people have varying perspectives about what that looks like. I really, to be quite honest with you right now, I really want some pickles and annihilators, but that's neither here nor there. Anyway, the point is that, you know, the purple kind. Like, I want some pickles and purple annihilators and some pizza. Like, that's where I'm coming from.
Well, at least you have pizza.
At least I have the pizza. I need to probably stop a bit at this store up here and go and get what I need so I can feel fulfilled tonight. The point, like, so when people say that, like, some people feel as though, like, you're not going to be effective in ministry. And ministry is just simply, like, somebody who is able, that has gone through something and has overcome it and is able to talk about their story to me. That's the way I interpret ministry. So, you know, you can't be effective. Some people feel as though you can't be effective in ministry, you know, unless you are a part of something. And I think that there's some truth to that. You know what I'm saying? But you don't want to be the kind of person that continues to just stay in the midst of foolishness over and over and over and over again and not overcome. Like, you want to get through something and then, like, get over it. Like, people tell me, for instance, like I mentioned to you guys, I call myself Hood Mom or Lip Gloss Hood Boss or, you know, Baby Mama Avenger, Baby Mama, all those kinds of things. And people are like, you don't have to say that, Remy. You don't have to call yourself that. But, you know, you've overcome certain things. You've overcome certain circumstances and all that other kind of stuff. But again, you know, that's a really long and drawn out kind of a conversation about, like, should you continue to remember that you made some decisions in your life that you're not necessarily proud of, or that you had to overcome some circumstances that were not ideal for you? Like, should you continue to remind yourself of that? Or somebody who has been in recovery or something like that, do you continue to call yourself in recovery, or do you say that you've overcome that? You know, that's a constant question for people that have overcome circumstances, people that have overcome certain trials and stuff like that. Like, what is the balance in that? And I'm saying that today's message for me, from the Hood Mom's perspective, is that I think that there's a very delicate balance. You never want to be in a situation that you're forgetting, like, you think that you're better than somebody, like you forgot what it looks like to, you know, experience certain things. You don't ever want to, because you will get humbled real quick. You can get right off that high horse real quick. So I think for me, you know, I am someone, so I don't want to get knocked down. I don't want to get knocked off no high horse. I just want to keep it humble, you know, and I want to keep it authentic. And that means that you don't have to put yourself in a situation to, you know, be common, you know, and be raggedy or be nothing. That's not what that means. But it is about being relatable. It is about being humble. It is about being, you know, accessible and transparent and relatable to people. I think that that's the kind of person that I want to be. That's the kind of person that I aspire to be, you know, that I can be relatable to anybody. I try to find at least some kind of common ground with anybody, you know, so that I can be human with them, you know. But that doesn't mean that you still have to persist in foolishness. You know, if you made some poor choices, you don't have to stay in the midst of those poor choices just because the people that's around you, you don't ever want to elevate above them, or you don't want to change the, nah, forget that. Now, that's a completely different situation. So that doesn't mean, just because you advance your cause, that doesn't mean, or your situation, or you evolve, or you elevate your circumstances, that doesn't mean that you're not authentic anymore. That doesn't mean that you're not real or anything like that. Just because you win, don't mean you soulless. You know, I hate that. I hate when people try to make you stay, keep you in confined to low expectations. Forget that. You know, don't be on that. Just because that's like, to me, that's the true ministry. you know, like, the true ministry is, like, after you have overcome that, like, look, my life, I was there. You see me there. I did that. But look at me now. You know, that's ministry. So, I don't know. But you ain't got to look back. You ain't got to feel bad about elevating your circumstances. You don't got to feel bad about not being raggedy no more. And if anybody try to make you... if anybody try to make you feel bad about being raggedy, you know what I want to say. For real. And keep it pressing. And I... Man. Because... Don't let nobody make... Right, Tegan? Did you eat my pizza? If somebody try to make... Man, I wish somebody would try to make me feel bad about not wanting to be on WIC no more.
Why?
Man, I would... Want some?
Yes.
I wish somebody would make me feel bad about not living in subsidized housing. No more. What's wrong with people? No, doesn't that even sound silly? Even talking like